of the wall.
He's out there. Got us a dirt track date. Demolition derby figure eight. Eating dinner off my favorite plate. Elimination start at eight. We got a dirt track date. You and me, babe. Dirt track date.
Cherokee Speedway, the place your mama warned you about. They say it's one of the fastest dirt tracks in the South. Each weekend, drivers come here to battle for the checkered flag. But unlike the multi-million dollar NASCAR circuit, drivers here are lucky if they go home with $100 and a bent fender. Most are racing purely for bragging rights, but there are a few with dreams of breaking into stock car racing's big leagues.
Everything I've done ever was racing, so really that's something I know how to do. If I had to go out and get a regular job, I'd be in trouble because I'd be lost. And I don't know what I'd do if I couldn't race.
22-year-old Clint Elkins has only been racing for two seasons, but he's already built an impressive record, and he's become the man to beat at Cherokee. Clint grew up in the South, the heart of stock car racing country. Today, he still lives on the North Carolina farm where his family has been for three generations.
It's our horse, Susie. She's about 25 now. She's been here longer than I have.
I'm not real interested in the farming. I never have been. I just always wanted to race. But I know Dad likes it. I help him on the farm, and he helps me on the race car. You know, it's kind of a trade-off deal.
Like a lot of kids, Clint picked up his interest in racing from his father.
Well, at first, I didn't really want him to. He came in one day with a race car. He got somewhere and said, "Now what are we going to do, Dad?" And I said, "I guess we're going to go racing."
And ever since, Clint's been tearing up the track at Cherokee.
Well, Cherokee Speedway is really special to me because it's my hometown track. I've been going there with my daddy since I was just a little boy and getting autographs from all the drivers. And, you know, now I've got my own fans.
He's really nice.
Yeah, he's sweet and very handsome.
Racing fans are a special breed. And for some at Cherokee, this is a way of life.
It's exciting. I mean, some people play baseball, they go to baseball games. Some people play football, they go to football games. We race, we go to the races.
I like the action. I like to see all the dirt flying and putting the pedal to the metal.
Great race cars, great people, great fans out here. Just love the atmosphere. It's a great place to be.
There's plenty of things to do in this world, and I wouldn't rather do anything else.
The excitement and action of racing is what I like best about it.
I like the wrecks.
Me? I like the wrecks, too.
Oh, it's just relaxing to me. I love the drivers.
Just sometimes in racing, you don't know what's going to happen.
I guess it's a southern thing, dirt track racing. Keeps us out of trouble.
I've been around racing all my life, basically. I mean, I just... I'm 11 years old.
Cherokee may be Clint's hometown track, but his dream lies here. At North Carolina's Charlotte Motor Speedway. In the world of professional stock car racing, this is the big time. Charlotte is just 50 miles from Cherokee, yet for Clint, it seems like a world away.
You know, I want to go Winston Cup racing or super late model racing for a living, but right now I got to kind of take my punishing because I hadn't got there yet. You know, this is my training. This is to see if I can make it or not.
Clint's big chance is only a week away in what could be his most important race ever. If he wins, it could launch his pro career and perhaps change his life. In the meantime, Clint has his hands full out in the dirt.
Dirt track conditions on the racetrack change so much. They can change 110% during the time of a race and go from getting
tack in wet to dry. You got to change your car. You got to change the way you drive. And asphalt's pretty much going to stay the same throughout the race, no matter if you're on 10 laps or 100 laps.
This year, Clint dusted the local competition. But next week, the top drivers from around the country are coming to Cherokee for the final race of the season. It's called the Blue Gray 100. This will be Clint's big chance to show the best in the business what he's made of. Many of stock car racing's greatest legends, like Richard Petty and Darrell Waltrip, also developed their skills on dirt before moving up to the super speedways like Daytona or Talladega. But some drivers came from a different background altogether. In the early 50s, the rural South was moonshine country, and the best drivers around were the bootleggers. Legends like Junior Johnson were always on the run from the law. So it's no wonder they became such good race car drivers. The police never caught Junior behind the wheel as a bootlegger, and he probably got more practice than just about anyone. He won 50 Grand National races. Racing has gotten a lot more sophisticated than it was in those early days. But the dirt track scene has remained close to its cultural roots.
I'd say this is mostly a blue-collar crowd out here at Cherokee Speedway, not a whole lot of uptown city people.
90% of the people out here have regular jobs, working 8 to 5, gas stations, or wherever, and come out and go work in the cars at night and come to the racetrack just for a hobby.
That's my son. He tried to tell me how to drive. I was driving when he wasn't even born.
But for Clint, racing is a lot more than just a hobby.
I'm the managing editor of Racing News. It's a nationwide paper. You know, we've got about 20,000 subscribers. We send papers to England, to Canada, wherever, you know, all over the U.S.
I travel around to different racetracks, write articles, write columns, and it's a really good way to meet people. It's a good way to get connections, you know, for my racing, and that's helped out a whole lot.
Clint meets a lot of characters who compete out here every weekend, and each one has a huge following of fans.
Some of the names these guys come up with, it's kind of like something you'd see in professional wrestling. Guys like the Night Stalker, he's supposedly from parts unknown. Then there's Mike Duval, he's the Flintstone Flyer. And then there's the Dirt Bobber.
Well, everybody else had numbers, but I wanted to be different, so I just came up with Dirt Bobber.
There's rivalries between the drivers. A lot of times, tensions get high. People's egos get the better of them. Just about every race, by the end of the night, someone's ready to fight.
When they come out here, they know they're going to tear these cars up. They've spent all week working on them. And when they get tore up, they get upset, they want to fight, so we just have to sort of keep peace between them and keep anybody from getting hurt, mainly.
Most of the time, things cool down, and by the next week, everybody's friends again.
So it's not uncommon for opposing teams to lend a tool or a part, all in the spirit of competition. After all, this is a place where families race side by side each week.
This is my family. This is a racing family. We do it 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, it seems. We paint, we do body work, we change tires, we carry gas, whatever needs to be done. It's drawn our family a lot closer together. We were kind of going our separate ways, and now we spend all our time together.
Getting ready for the Blue Gray 100 keeps Clint and his dad hard at work together, too.
My dad and I, we both just love racing. That's all we think about. That's all we do. We've got two race cars, and with all the beating and banging that goes on, you know, you've got some repair work to do about every week.
There are only a couple of days till the big race, and by tomorrow, the professional teams and sponsors will be rolling in.
Excuse me, Opie. But you always want to make sure everything's right, but yeah, the Blue Gray's more important. We've got a good chance here to show what we can do in front of all these people. This is kind of like an audition for us.
You have to get in the zone when you're driving. You can't let your mind wander anything else because you're on the ragged edge. Just one slip and you've lost the race. You'll smack the wall or miss the groove. So you got to stay 100% focused.
Come on, baby, take a ride with me.
Oh,
Mississippi down to New Orleans.
You gotta have a good car. You gotta have a good motor. You got to have somebody that'll get on the gas, that's not afraid to put it up front. And you've got to be aggressive, or you won't win a race at all. It can be dangerous, but there's a lot more things to be doing that's more dangerous. You know, you hear about people all the time on Saturday nights out drinking beer and crashing the car and getting killed. I mean, this is probably right here about the safest thing you can be doing.
If there's one Cherokee driver who Clint can take advice from before the big event, it's 62-year-old Billy Scott. Billy blazed through four decades, winning races all over the South. He even had a shot at a pro career, but Billy chose family over fame.
That's one thing that I could say, my family come first for us racing. You got to give it full time, you got to quit your job, and you got to follow the racing to make it. And I never would do that. But I'm happy with my career. I've done what I wanted to do, and I've won, you know, all kind of races.
After all these years, Billy is still racing at Cherokee, and the fans just can't get enough of him.
They get so excited, you know, and it does something to me just to win for them, but of course, I'm American, and I like to win.
It's race day, and professional teams from across the country are showing up for the Blue Gray 100.
I've been on the road so long, it seems that all I can taste is gasoline.
You could say this race is based on emotions that date back to the Civil War. They don't call it the Blue Gray for nothing. And this weekend, Clint and the local drivers are ready to defend their turf against the invasion of big money teams from around the country. At an event like this, there's as much action going on in the pit area as there is out on the racetrack. And the Cherokee infield is full of hardcore race fans. There's one area where emotions run particularly high.
Down in Turn 1 and 2 is the Chicken Bone Alley. There's people been coming down there for years and years and years and parking in the same spot. Yeah, I've always heard there's people killed down there in Turns 1 and 2 and you never find out about it. You know, you don't go in Chicken Bone Alley. This is probably one of the most important races for me of my career because there's a ton of people that are here that could help us out. We need a good showing. We need to really showcase our talents this weekend for everybody that's there.
But not everyone has come looking to sponsor new talent. There are some drivers in town that would like nothing better than to take out Clint Elkins.
He's going to be fast, but I think we can get as fast as he is.
Number 51, Jamie Pate is on a mission.
When you come to a place, the first thing you want to do is find out who's the baddest thing there. So you can focus on that man to try to catch him. The next thing you got to do is pass him. Clint's tough. This is his home track. Clint's a good race car driver. And when you run up against somebody that's got nice equipment and is at their home track, it's going to just be hard to outrun.
If I take my time and work my way through the field, I can get up there and run with him.
Clint qualifies to start in the number 4 slot, while Jamie must battle his way up from the back of the pack. With only 15 laps to race, Jamie Pate's going to have to get on the gas to catch Clint. But in racing, anything can happen. Clint, in the black C1 car, takes the high line and advances to second place. But Jamie is also driving hard, and his number 51 car is now within striking distance. There are only 5 laps to go. Clint prepares to make his move on the lead car.
One of the things I like to do is, when I'm running behind somebody, I like to pressure them and try to make them mess up. If they know I'm there, then they'll run their car a little harder and maybe mess themselves up and they'll drive around.
Then, something goes wrong.
Out of five car right up next to the wall in turn one. A little out of shape, turn two. Elk is past the back of him. They hung together.
The cars lock bumpers.
Go to the inside. He gets him a mud bash.
Something's broke.
The collision damages Clint's steering box, and for him, the race is over. Jamie finishes fifth.
We had a good day. We're satisfied. We'll go home with a smile on our face today. Come back next time.
Well, it looks like today just wasn't my day. I know I shouldn't get so upset about it, but I just take it really hard. And that's one of the things I've got to work on, because that's part of racing. I know there's always going to be another race, and you can bet that next year I'll be the one gunning for the checkered flag. You know, I'll race because I love it, and I want to take this as far as I can. I want to win the Daytona 500, and I want to win the Winston Cup Championship, and that's what I use as motivation. Now, I want to be the best. Someday, I'm going to make it.